In this video, I'm going to be unboxing and reviewing the Sunlu Filadryer S1. By the end of the video, you're going to have all the information you need to decide whether to buy one or not. I'm not going to go into all the specs in the video because, let's face it, that will get boring. Everything will be down in the description. You may or may not know that I built a filament storage dry box that a lot of people have found useful. I've had quite a few comments on that video, some of which were, why shouldn't I just buy the Sunlu S1 Filadryer? I didn't have one, so I used some of the money that you guys gave me for coffees to go out and buy one and try and answer that question. The S1 isn't a new product. At time of recording, it's been out for about a year, but recently, because of the rumours of the S2 coming along, the prices have come down on the S1, so it may make it a bit more attractive to buy now rather than waiting for the S2 to arrive. Let's try and keep this as quick and to the point as we can. The Sunlu S1 is marketed not only as a filament dryer, but also as a filament dry box. The Sunlu website states that the Sunlu dry box is specifically made for the purpose of drying 3D printer filament. It's intended to remove moisture from a spool of filament. It can keep 3D filament dry during a print job and can be used to dry filament for storage. So with that in mind, I'm going to test how well it dries filament and how well it keeps it dry. Firstly, let's get it out of the box. The box I received from Amazon was a little beaten up, so hopefully there's no damage. Inside the box, you get the S1 inside a protective bag, which thankfully has kept my unit from being damaged. Once you have it out of the bag, you'll see the S1 in all its glory. It's got a hinged lid with all the controls and display at the front. Now, this is the first thing that annoys me about this product. With the lid fully open, the lid sits down lower than the base, which means if you put it on a flat surface, it doesn't sit flat. Not a major problem, but annoying for someone like me. Anyway, inside the box, you get a nice big piece of non-recyclable foam holding a power supply. Inside the lid, you get a small bag of spare sleeves for the hole where the filament feeds out. The power supply plugs into the back and you're ready to go. Just press one of the buttons on the front and you're shown the temperature inside the box. Hit either of the buttons again and you're shown the temperature that it's trying to reach. The button on the right increases the temperature, the button on the left reduces it. The heating element inside starts to heat up immediately. I checked the temperature after a few minutes and it was already up to 106 degrees. Now, this is obviously hot enough to boil water, so don't go putting your hand in there as you will get a burn. You can also change the amount of time that the heater runs for. Just press and hold the button on the left and you get a time display. Again, the right hand button increases, left hand button decreases. You get the idea. And once you've got your time selected, just hold down the left button again until you go back to your temperature display. That's all there is to the controls, so let's now put a roll of filament inside and see if it does what it says it does. Now here's the next thing that annoys me about this box. This little rubber bung that goes in the front here falls out pretty much every time you open the lid and is no doubt going to get lost within days. Any 1 kilogram roll is going to fit inside the box and just sit on the rollers and turn as you feed filament out. You've got two holes that you can feed the filament out of, but I wouldn't use this one here because as the filament comes out of it, it actually pulls on the lid, pops the box open. If you're enjoying this video, hit like and subscribe. I make content that's aimed at helping people just like you. Subscribing helps to get YouTube to take me more seriously, but it also helps you find the content you want. Right, let's see how quickly it heats up. I've blocked the top hole with a bung to simulate a Bowden tube of filament blocking the hole. With a thermometer inside and a time lapse to stop us getting bored, we can see that the air temperature hits 36 degrees C after 30 minutes and remains pretty stable from then on. This is with the target temperature at 55 degrees and the thermometer sitting in the middle of the box. The relative humidity also comes down to 45% and stabilises after about 45 minutes. I was interested to see what would happen if we just let the warm air out of the box, so I took all the bungs out and held the lid open with a skewer. Interestingly, the temperature barely changed, but the relative humidity decreased to 27%. Now for those of you that know me, know that I'm not going to let this little bit of information go to waste. We'll definitely do something with that later. Right, let's try and dry something. Rather than messing about with rolls of filament where we don't even know the moisture content before we start, I'm going to use floral foam so we can accurately see what's going on. Here I'm adding exactly 2 grams of water to the foam and then putting it inside the box with the holes blocked up as the manufacturer seems to want us to use it. I ran the heat on full for 6 hours to see what happens. As you can clearly see, the moisture is being removed from the foam as we can see the condensation on the inside of the lid. And understandably, the relative humidity is a lot higher with the extra moisture in the air. After 6 hours of drying, the foam now weighs 1.58 grams. That means that 1.27 grams of water has been removed by the S1 in 6 hours. That's obviously good, but we can clearly see where that water's gone. It's on the inside of the lid. So what have we learnt? Yes, you can print with filament inside the box. Yes, it dries stuff, but that moisture doesn't leave the box. It just sits on the inside, ready to be reabsorbed back into your filament. We already suspect that letting the air out might actually improve things. I feel like more investigation is necessary. If you want to know more, check out one of these two videos. This one will show you how the Sunlu compares to one of the best options out there for keeping your filament dry, and then this video will show you how to take the Sunlu and turn it into the product that maybe they should have made in the first place. Thanks for watching.